Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
What could I possibly say about the relationship between Christian faith and the reading of the pagan classics that hasn't been stated much more eloquently already in other places? I initially considered simply summarizing the highlights of the various wonderfully articulated defenses of the importance of appreciating the best of the pre-Christian culture offered, but I decided that it may be more meaningful to approach this subject from the perspective of a personal narrative. First thing first, the Holy Fathers are absolutely adamant that there is real God-inspired virtue and wisdom in the classics of pagan literature and Hellenic culture. This isn't up for debate. The Holy Fathers were living repositories of all the best that their cultures had to offer, from the Apostolic Fathers to the three holy hierarchs that we commemorate today, to the pillars of Orthodoxy and beyond. The answer to Tertullian's question as to what does Athens have to do with Jerusalem is actually a whole lot. But what does that really mean for me? I'm an average guy in the 21st century, and I confess, perhaps with some embarrassment, that I wasn't really raised on the great classics of fantasy and mythology because they never drew me in the same way that books on American history, the World Wars, geography, and things that, well, take place in this world. Even today, I will still choose to read someone like Graham Greene over Tolkien, forgive me. I say all of this to raise an important question that I feel is sometimes neglected in discussions about Christian faith and non-Christian culture. We may respond with a resounding yes to the value of classical literature in the eyes of the Holy Fathers of the Church. But we also need to ask why this matters to us today. How does Homer, the Epic of Gilgamesh, Grimm's fairy tales, or the tales of the Norse gods, teach one about virtue, especially as someone who doesn't particularly consider themselves to be a huge fan of fantasy? I found the answer through working as a teacher. I discovered, much like St. Basil, that behind every myth is a human story, an example of man's introspective drive to know who he is. In classical literature, in fairy tales, in stories of the gods, we see man asking questions about himself that demand to be answered. In that sense, myths represent the most authentic form of human knowledge, because it is not the knowledge of mere facts, but the collective wisdom of experience. That experience can never be reproduced, and yet it is never forgotten because it is a facet of man's very nature. And as I've learned to appreciate fantasy and mythology, if not necessarily as entertainment, from an existential point of view, from the perspective that living truthfully and meaningfully is what matters above all else, we must therefore understand that the Holy Fathers of the Church don't suggest we read pagan literature in order to glean abstract lessons in some vague notion of virtue. Virtue is tears. It is somehow finding the strength to rise to your feet after your thousandth failure and meekly say, "Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on me." Virtue is found in stories because human life is a story. We would never understand what virtue is if it were a series of platitudinous mantras existing off in the ether of the mind. Humankind is a story that God is writing always through us, not just in the texts of the Bible or the lives of the saints, as vital as they are. Stories enable us to make sense of who we are and why we do the things we do. That's why the Holy Fathers tell us to read the classics. That's why the church sought to transfigure rather than destroy pre-Christian culture. Storytelling is to mankind like breathing. We need it to live authentically human lives. We need it to see how God is truly everywhere present and filling all things. We need it because God gave it to us. We tell stories because we are stories that God is writing. Let us learn from the Holy Fathers, among them especially the three Holy Hierarchs, to see ourselves as part of mankind's story toward Christ, and dig beneath the surface of every fairy tale, every epic, every story of the gods, and see in it the God-breathed desire for truth and meaning, a desire that points the way toward Him. Thank you.